डाली हो। यूथ पार्लियामेंट के राष्ट्रीय विजेता इन्हीं युवाओं की आवाजें हैं। आज ये अपने मन की बात आपसे शेयर करना चाहते हैं। सबसे पहले मंच पर आमंत्रण है महाराष्ट्र से श्वेता उमरे, आपको आपसे निवेदन है कि कृपया अपने विचार प्रकट करें।
मैं उस देश की नागरिक हूँ जहाँ छत्रपति शिवाजी महाराज और सम्राट अशोक जैसा राजा था। मैं उस देश की नागरिक हूँ जहाँ हर 50 मील पर रूप, पहनावा, मजहब बदल जाता था। मैं उस देश की नागरिक हूँ जहाँ डाल डाल पर सोने की चिड़िया को पाया जाता था। मैं उस देश की नागरिक हूँ जिसे अपने भूगोल के पहले इस ब्रह्मांड का भूगोल समझ आता था। अ वेरी फ्रेनेटिक मॉर्निंग टू ऑनरेबल प्राइम मिनिस्टर सर, रिस्पेक्टेड मिनिस्टर सर। This is Shweta Umre from Government Institute of Forensic Sciences, Rashtrasant Tukdoji Maharaj University, Nagpur, Maharashtra. Today, I will be speaking on the topic Connecting India Economically, Culturally and Geographically. Now, when I look at this topic, I can see two aspects. The first aspect is how do we connect India to itself? The second aspect is how do we connect India to other countries globally? So when I talk about the first aspect, I dearly feel that India is already a connected nation. Now how? NASA has reportedly stated that the sound of the rotation of Earth is Om. And we have been worshipping Om, we have been worshipping landscapes, rivers, lakes since ages now, which states that our culture is born out of the geography of our country. Moving ahead to how culture is connected to the economy. When I talk on this, how can I not talk about the heritage tourism that we have, about Chardham, about Golden Temple, about Haji Ali Dargah, about the beautiful churches of Goa. This heritage tourism generates revenue for our nation, and this revenue helps us build a better, a stronger economy. And that we have a stronger economy now, it is possible for us to reach to the portions of the country that are in the most remote areas. And this would lead to not only literate individuals, but educated individuals. And educated individuals of this nation would arise and develop a better and stronger culture, would arise and take care of the geography of their nation. And when this would happen, our India would arise. Talking of geography, when I see that people who drink water in Bengal, it comes from the Himalayas. The people who experience rainfalls in Mumbai are the clouds that are coming from Gujarat. And we have the second largest network of roads in the world, thanks to the 3% taxpayers of this country. Ahead, I would like to state how India is getting connected to other countries globally. India has always been rich in cultivable land, rich in heritage, and rich is amongst all of you beautiful youth people of this country. This is the reason why countries like superpowers want to come to us and invest on our land. This does not only bring pride and respect to my country, it also generates a very strong economical relationship with countries that are more developed than ours. This is how economical bonds form between two countries, and this is how we start understanding each other's geography. And when economy and geography of two countries mix, there is an exchange of cultures. We adapt their culture, they adapt our culture. With this, I would like to state that the only thing that the youth of India can do is to strengthen this connection that already exists within and inter India. How can we do this? We can do this by taking active participation and understanding what our responsibilities and our duties towards our country, our nation, our people are. And the day we realize our responsibilities, the day we start working hard, the face of this nation will change. And let's do this. Let's hold our hands, work even harder, and let's do what India was born to do, to build love, to build respect, and to generate peace. I would like to end my say with the quote. Jis din teri fateh ka parcham is mitti par lehraega, jis din teri fateh ka parcham is mitti par lehraega, kya zami kya aasma ye Hindustan mil jayega. With this, I end my say, Jai Hind!